Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to see about the ionization of weak electrolyte and common ion effect. Ionization of weak electrolyte. And common ion effect. Okay. In ionization of weak electrolyte, that means weak acid or weak base. What is called weak electrolyte? Okay. The electrolyte which completely dissociated, they are called as a strong electrolyte. If electrolyte is completely dissociated, they are called as a strong electrolyte. If they are partially dissociated, they are not completely dissociated, mean they are called as a weak electrolyte. For example, we are going to take HA as a weak acid. It's a weak electrolyte. If you assume that when it is added to the water, there is a equilibrium exists between these A-. See, there is an equilibrium exists between the undissociated ions and the dissociated particles. That's why HA is called as a weak electrolyte. Okay. If you write the equilibrium constant Ka for this, there is a concentration of product. What are the product? These two are product. Divided by the concentration of the reactant. What are the reactant? So nothing but when a weak electrolyte, they having the equilibrium exists between the dissociated and undissociated particle. If you write the, since the equilibrium is arises, we are writing the K C. Equilibrium constant based on the concentration Kc. If you write like this, it will come. For a dilution, during the dilution, the concentration of water is more. So let me take the concentration of water as a K. The large amount of water will be taken. The concentration of water will be large, so it is taken as a constant K. Okay. H3O plus, for our convenient purpose. Okay, it is hydrated. H plus ion, so I am taking as a H plus simply. Okay. The concentration of water is taken as a K because we are taking large amount. The concentration of hydronium ion I am taking as a H plus for our convenient purpose. Okay. Then let us substitute this in here. Kc, that is equal to H3O plus, instead of H3O plus, I am substituting H plus ion. H plus. Okay. Then A minus divided by HA. For the water, I am adding K. Okay. If KC into K, that is equal to H plus A minus divided by HA. The equation will become like this. Okay. We know that Kc is a equilibrium constant, Ka is another one constant. The product of these two constants is can given by Ka. Okay. So I am going to substitute Kc into K, that is equal to Ka, that is another constant. Ka, that is equal to H plus A minus divided by C. Okay. Ka is nothing but Ka is a dissociation constant. Dissociation constant for a weak acid. If it is a Kb, constant of weak acid, If you take a, because weak electron may be weak acid or a weak base. Okay. So, for if you take a dissociation constant for weak base, that should be Kb. For dissociation constant for acid, Ka. The A for acid, this is a constant. Dissociation constant for weak acid, Ka. Then the relation may be given this like this. This is a ionization of weak acid. Okay. What is there during the ionization? There is a equilibrium exists between the two dissociated particle and undissociated particle. So if your equilibrium exists, mean we can calculate the equilibrium constant Kc. From this, we are getting the dissociation constant Ka value. Based on this, Ahswald giving us some law that is called Ahswald dilution law. Ahswald's dilution law. Very, very important law. Ahswald dilution law. What is there in Ahswald dilution law? It relates the law which relates the concentration C, dissociation constant Ka, and the degree of dissociation alpha. It is giving a relationship between the concentration and dissociation constant and a degree of dissociation alpha. Alpha is nothing but a degree of dissociation. Alpha is degree of dissociation. Degree of dissociation. It can, what is the formula for the alpha? Alpha can be get from the number of moles dissociated. Number of moles dissociated divided by total number of moles divided by total number of moles taken. See, degree of dissociation is nothing but how much amount of number of moles are dissociated to that total number of moles is taken. That is called the degree of dissociation alpha. Okay. Now I can explain the Ahswald dilution law. Ahswald dilution law is nothing but which relates the concentration, dissociation constant and a degree of dissociation. Simply saying that what is the statement of Ahswald dilution law is nothing but which relates the concentration, dissociation constant and a degree of dissociation. It says that when a dilution increases, degree of dissociation also increases. When a dilution increases during the dilution, degree of dissociation increases for weak electrolyte, that is must. Ahswald dilution law only for a weak electrolyte. When a dilution increases, degree of dissociation also increases. That is the Ahswald dilution law. Let me explain with a suitable example. I am taking a weak electrolyte, that is weak acid, acetic acid. Okay. For the example, I am taking a weak electrolyte, weak acid, acetic acid. Acetic acid is taken. But how acetic acid will be ionized? Acetic acid will be ionized to the it is a weak, since weak, there is equilibrium exists between the acetate ion plus H plus. Okay, there is a equilibrium exists, so equilibrium symbol is there. Since it's equilibrium exists, you can write the equilibrium constant or dissociation constant can be written as like this from the dilution law. We are getting that a concentration of product divided by the concentration of reactant. This is the concentration of the reactant. This is the Ka value. Now we are in the position to have a concentration and we need to get. So there is a table form. I will get it to how we can get the concentration. Have a table like this. Here. Okay. Table. Here. Acetic acid, then H plus acetic ion. Acetic ion. Okay. Acetic acid, H plus acetic ion. Initial number of moles. Initial number of moles. Initial number of moles. When an initial number of moles is taken, assume that we are taking one mole, for example, one mole is taken. one mole is taken. What about the initial number of moles? There is no, before dissociation, nothing is there. So, leave it. So, initial number of moles is taken, for one mole, we can take it. Then, number of moles dissociated. Number of moles dissociated. Let me say, imaginary, alpha amount of moles are dissociated. Okay, then nothing will be there here also, second term only. Okay, then number of moles at equilibrium, number of moles at equilibrium, see, initially one mole is taken, alpha amount of moles are dissociated, so how much amount of moles will be there? 1 minus alpha. 1 minus alpha, because initial number of moles taken is 1 mole, then alpha amount of moles are taken, dissociated, so 1 minus alpha, this is the number of moles at equilibrium. So here, at equilibrium, here alpha amount of H plus and acetate ion will be there. Then concentration at equilibrium, concentration at equilibrium. Concentration at equilibrium. See, into C. 1 minus alpha into C. C into alpha. C into alpha. So, this is a piece we need for the full substitute here. That's why we are doing the table. So, what is the table explain as the, just we are taking acetic acid, it is ionized into H plus and acetate ion. Initial number of moles for assumption, we are assuming that 1 mole is taken. 1 mole is taken, there is no chance of H plus and CH3O at initially. The number of moles after dissociation, diluted, you may get alpha moles of acetic acid is dissociated. So, nothing is there. Number of moles at equilibrium, if you see at equilibrium, because the equilibrium exists between the dissociated and undissociated particle. So, at equilibrium number of moles, initially 1 mole is taken, alpha amount of moles are dissociated. So, 1 minus alpha. Here, alpha we have. Then the concentration at equilibrium. So, what is the concentration of acetic acid at equilibrium? 1 minus alpha into C. Then the concentration of H plus ion C into alpha, the concentration of acetate ion C into alpha. Okay, because equal amount is dissociated. Then this is the concentration within the bracket in chemistry. If within the bracket is written, that is assumed to be concentration. So we need to calculate the dissociation constant Ka. We need the concentration of these three. These three are there. We get it. So from the table, I am substituting here. What is the acetate ion concentration? C into alpha. What is the concentration of H plus ion? That is also C into alpha. What is the concentration of acetic acid? That is 1 minus alpha into C. Okay. Then C cancelled. Ka equal to alpha square C by 1 minus alpha. Ka equal to alpha square C into 1 minus divided by 1 minus alpha. This is called the dissociation constant, can be calculated from this. Okay. For the dilution, the degree of dissociation value is too much less. Like this. Assume that. So this factor can be neglected. For a dilution of weak electrolyte, the degree of dissociation is very, very less. It may be 0.0001. So it can be neglected. Then Ka equal to alpha square C. This is the problem. Ka equal to alpha square C. Okay. Ka equal to alpha square C. Then, from this, whatever we can calculate. From the Ka, we want alpha mean. Ka equal to alpha square C. Then, Ka by C equal to alpha square. Then root of Ka by C equal to alpha. So this we can get alpha value. See, k equal to alpha squared c, k by c equal to alpha squared, alpha equal to k. Then degree of dissociation also can be calculated. From this, we can calculate the degree of dissociation. See, what is the Ostwald dilution law? According to Ostwald dilution law, when a dilution increases, degree of dissociation of the weak electrolyte also increases. That I need to prove, no? So for consideration, you take concentration, imaginary concentration, 10 power minus 2 in moles. Mole per liter, concentration of this mole per liter. The two cases, case number one, 10 power minus 2, C1, C2, two concentration if you take. Let me explain how the dilution increases the degree of dissociation based on the Ostwald dilution law. Ka value, that is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 4. You take this, 4 into 10 power minus 4. You apply this alpha value, you can calculate for two cases, for C1, Ka1 for the first case. If you take this case, what is this? When C is 10 power minus 2, if you put alpha, Ka, alpha equal to root of Ka by C. If you substitute Ka value, 4 into 10 power minus 4, where C is 10 power minus 2. If you take this, 4 into 10 power minus 2, that is 2 into 10 power minus 1, that is 0.2. Degree of dissociation for this case, case number 1, when a concentration is 10 power minus 2, then 0.2. The same case, if we take alpha in the concentration C2, that is 10 power minus 4 C value, if we put what is the alpha? Alpha equal to Ka by C. That is equal to 4 into 10 power minus 4 by 10 power minus 4. 4. 10 power minus 4, 10 power minus 4 cancel. That is equal to 2. Alpha equal to 2. See, this is case number 2. So what is the difference? Well, let us relate. When the concentration is 10 power minus 4, minus 2, you are getting this value. When at concentration 10 power minus 2, you are getting this value. What is happening? What is change in the concentration? Concentration 10 power minus 2 to 10 power minus 4. Concentration is diluted. Okay. The concentration is being like this. Dilution 100 times increases between these two. Okay. 100 times increases. Dilution increases. Concentration decreases. Concentration decreases. Dilution 100 times increases. Okay. Then what about the alpha? Alpha for this case 0.2. For this case, 2. See, 10 times increases. So from this factor, I can say that when a dilution concentration decreases 100 times, that means dilution also decreases 100 times, the alpha, degree of dissociation, increases 10 times. So this is Ostwald dilution law statement. Ostwald dilution law statement is nothing but when a concentration decreases, that means dilution increases, concentration decreases, dilution increases, degree of dissociation also increases. For the weak electrolyte, the Ostwald dilution law only applicable for a weak electrolyte, not for a strong electrolyte. For a weak electrolyte, when a dilution increases, degree of dissociation also increases. That is, factorize 100 times concentration decreases, 100 times dilution increases, 10 times degree of dissociation increases. This is, from this calculation, we can come to the conclusion that likewise. So, what is the Ostwald dilution law? Ostwald dilution law relates the C, concentration, alpha, degree of dissociation, and Ka for a dissociation constant, which relates these three. What is the statement of the Ostwald dilution law? So simply we can say, Ostwald dilution law says that when a dilution increases, degree of dissociation also increases for the weak electrolyte. From this extension form of the, for this is, we are taking for only acid, weak acid. If you take a weak base, the same formula will be changes to KB, that is base, only variation B. KA, A for acid, that is a dissociation constant for acid. KB, here, that is a dissociation constant for basic, that is a weak base. For example, that is same formula will come. alpha square c, then what is the alpha? Alpha mean root of kb by c, because in the problem they may give a base, weak base, sodium ammonium hydroxide like this, they will, you know, weak base, then you have to apply this formulas. Then above this, what else we can calculate? H plus ion concentration also we can calculate, because as well dilution, what is H plus ion concentration? We have taken C into alpha. H plus ion concentration, that is equal to C into alpha. You know what is the alpha value? Alpha value, that is Ka by C. Ka by C. Alpha value Ka by C. Then you are simplifying this, the C can be written root C into root C. Then Ka by root of Ka by C, that is root C. This root C to this root C cancel. So entirely root of Ka into C. H plus ion concentration. This is also used in the problem. Okay. If they ask, if you given the weak base, what to do? OH minus ion. OH minus ion concentration. OH minus ion concentration for weak base, the same way we can calculate root of Kb into C. So simple changes. Ka for weak acid, Kb for weak base. These are the various formation of Ostwald dilution law. For the problems, we can do it. Okay, that's all about the Ostwald dilution law. Let us move on to the common ion effect. Let us see the common ion effect. Common ion, what is the common ion effect first of all? Reduction of degree of dissociation when a salt of the weak acid is added to that electrolyte. It's a simple thing. For example, if you take a acetic acid. Acetic acid is a weak acid. Acetic acid is a weak acid. Okay. It dissociated, partially dissociated. There is equilibrium exists between the acetate ion and the H plus. Okay. This is the undissociated part. This is the dissociated part. There is equilibrium exists between. When a addition of the salt of the weak acid, see for example, if we take acetic acid, if we take sodium acetate is taken, sodium acetate. Why I am taking this? This is a salt of this particular weak acid, sodium acetate. How this sodium acetate is formed? Acetic acid plus NaOH, you are getting that is sodium acetate, CH3COOH. Okay, weak acid, strong base, you are getting that is the salt of the weak acid you are getting, sodium acetate. This is a strong electrolyte, not weak electrolyte. So this is a symbol variation. See, look at here. This equilibrium symbol is I am giving, but it is a forward arrow mark. Only this says that it is completely ionized or dissociated. Completely ionized or dissociated. See how this is a already weak electrolyte, partially only dissociation is there. While I am adding, if I take, see. Here, first of all, acetic acid is there. Then I am pouring or adding a sodium acetate. What happened? These are the common ion. See, look at the common ion. Common ion is there. This is called common ion. So, what happened in the beaker, if I take this, the concentration of acetate ion increases due to the when addition of the salt, concentration of acetate ion increases because while the increase in the acetate ion concentration, equilibrium will be disturbed. Equilibrium will be disturbed because the forward direction more concentration is increases. According to Lee-Chatelier principle, what he is saying? Whenever any disturbance given to the equilibrium, equilibrium tends to nullify the disturbance. If any disturbance is given to the equilibrium tends to nullify the disturbance. How they will nullify? Because it will, again, backward direction, it will favor the reaction. Okay. So, if the backward direction reaction is favored, what happens? The dissociation decreases. Okay. This is called a common ion effect. Once again, I am explaining, the decreases in the degree of dissociation due to the common ion is called common ion effect. When a common ion is produced, an addition of the salt is added, few amount of salt is added to that weak electrolyte. This is a weak electrolyte. I am adding the salt of the weak electrolyte to that. Because of the addition of the salt, the common ion is produced. Due to the production of common ion, the degree of dissociation of acetic acid is decreased. Why it is decreasing? Based on the Lee-Chudley principle, when a common ion is produced, the concentration of forward direction is more. That is, acetate ion concentration increases. Because of the increases of the acetate ion concentration, the reaction, the equilibrium is disturbed. According to Lee-Chudley is saying this, any disturbance given to the equilibrium tends to nullify the disturbance. So how they are nullifying? If concentration increases on forward direction, what happens? Automatically the reaction favors towards the backward direction. What it means? If reaction favors towards the backward direction, the concentration of acetic acid will be increases. So the net totally, if we calculate it, the dissociation is decreases. Net dissociation will be decreases. Formally, I am taking for simplest take the explanation for you. Acetic acid taken, it is going to dissociate it. Okay, some amount will be dissociating. When is I am adding a common ion by the form of salt, how much dissociated alone it will be decreased. Total amount of dissociation will be decreased. That's why it is the reduction of degree of dissociation or decreases in the degree of dissociation due to the common ion is called a common ion effect. Okay, this is explained for the common ion effect. Now it's clear. Okay, let us see some problems. Based on this Ostwald dilution law. See, first type of problem you can see, concentration will be provided. Okay, concentration 0.10 m. Alpha, degree of dissociation given 1.220%. What is the dissociation constant? They asked question. So you have a formula Ka equal to alpha square c. That is your formula. You are having that alpha square c. Now Ka is needed, so alpha is given. Alpha, you have to convert this, otherwise it will make confusion. 1.20/100. Or otherwise 1.20 × 10⁻². Okay, it will be easy to apply. That is alpha. Then if you write 1.20 × 10⁻², into 1.20 × 10⁻², what is this c? C is 10⁻¹. You can change it 1 × 10⁻ −1. That is 1 × 10⁻². Okay. Then that is a value is 1.44 × 10⁻⁵. That's a Ka value. You can get it like this. Okay, simple. Then second type of problem. pH is asked. See, pH is asked. What else is given? Concentration is given. Dissociation constant also will be given. It's in the wording form. I am writing the data alone. You go through in the book, you can see that. pH is asked. They are given a concentration, 0.1 more concentration acetic acid, Ka is given. We need a pH. What to do? Before that pH, you want to pH mean, what is the formula? pH equal to minus log of H plus ion concentration. Okay. Then you need H plus ion concentration first. H plus ion concentration, that is the formula, that is root of KC. Okay. Now K is there, C is there, from the H plus you can calculate. After the H plus calculation, you can go to the pH. Okay. Now Ka, what is the Ka value? Ka value 1.8 × 10⁵−5. C equal to 0.1, that is 10⁻¹. You apply C values here. Then 1.8 × 10⁻⁶. Okay. Then the value will be H plus ion concentration, if you take a root, 1.34 × 10⁻³. 10 power, that is 1.8 if you take. This is H plus ion concentration. Based on this, we need to calculate the pH. pH equal to minus log of H plus ion concentration. Okay. That is minus log of 1.34 × 10⁻³. It can be written minus already out here, minus 3 minus log of 1.34. Okay, log of 1.34, that is equal to minus into minus plus plus 3 minus log of 1.34 value is 0.127 ohm. If you apply, that is around 2.8. pH is 2.8. Since it is a concentration of acetic acid, mean directly we can have it 2.8. This is a formula. Okay. See, pH is asked, they are given only concentration and Ka value. From this concentration and Ka value, we are getting H plus ion concentration. After getting the H plus ion concentration, we are getting the pH. Then Kb is given, dissociation constant per weak base, ammonium hydroxide for example. That is ammonium hydroxide is given, dissociation constant per weak base. The concentration is provided. They asking alpha value, degree of dissociation. That is they are asked. See, different. First problem we are seeing Ka, second pH, then alpha. So what, how we can get the alpha value? Alpha is nothing but alpha equal to root of Ka, sorry, this is a base, so Kb into C. So Kb is given root of 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 into C. Okay. Sorry, alpha is asked. No, alpha being, it is H plus I would be alpha equal to root of Ka by C. This is the formula. Root of Ka value 1.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 divided by 0.06. Okay. Let me write 0.06 and 1.8 for the convenient purpose. 18 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 6 into 10 to the power minus 2. Okay. If you alter 3 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay. 3 into 10 to the power minus 4. Root 3 value you know. 23 is 1.73 into 10 to the power minus 2. This is alpha. Or this is what is mean 7.3 by 100 or otherwise 1.73% degree of dissociation in percentage. You can write 1.373%. This is where you can get the alpha value. See, Kb is given, C also is there. Alpha equal to root of Ka by C, then Ka value and C value, you substitute, you finally get that alpha, degree of dissociation 1.73%. These like problems you may have in both theory and NEET. Thank you.